Today on Internet Marketing Pro, how to get the most from your blog post. Are you legally minimizing your future tax burden and staying compliant in today's complex tax code? If not, our podcast show sponsor, McLew Consulting, has over 30 years of experience providing top quality professional services in accounting and tax preparation for a wide variety of clients like you. Whether you need tax return filing, planning, bookkeeping, financial statements, full service payroll, or a corporate or individual tax return filing, I personally endorse you to contact Jeffrey Ressler, CPA, at 561-237-5264. That number again is 561-237-5264. And you can visit their website at jrcpa.net. That's jrcpa.net. Tell Jeff that Chad Deckard sent you from this podcast to receive his special rate for listening to this show. Thank you very much. Broadcasting from the city of sun and rain off the Atlantic Ocean in Boca Raton, Florida. Good morning, good evening, wherever you may be across the nation and around the world. I'm your host, Chad Deckard, and welcome to my Internet Marketing Pro podcast show. My shows will cover how to grow your business, as well as topics on tips, tricks, and techniques, digital lifestyles, the future of finance, and entrepreneurism. Thank you for tuning into my show as we begin this adventure together, exploring many great things to come. Now, let's cover a few quick announcements before we get started. I really appreciate all the feedback that I've been getting. What a difference it makes in motivating me to put these shows out and continually think of the next subject matter that I'd like to explore with you all. I am also very excited about you all helping me get more subscribers and by sharing my content with your social network. My weekly listener base is growing a great deal week after week, and that's the greatest payoff my listeners can do for me in giving back for my time and efforts in putting into this show. If you like my show and find it resourceful, please do your social network a favor and share, like, post, leave a comment, and subscribe to my show. I greatly appreciate your efforts and support. Now, let's get down to business. So today's show is how to get the most from your blog post. Kind of a catchy phrase and title there. And so, this is kind of really more of an exercise. So for those of you who are tuning in, to this show, you might want to grab your pen and a piece of paper and maybe take a little time to sit around and think about this. And you might even want to pause the program at certain points because we're going to use this program to do something a little different than I've never done before in all my shows. And that's kind of like me being the consultant as if I was really talking on the phone with you, walking you through how to determine about getting the most from your blog post. And I'm going to take you through this exercise and help you find the best way to approach coming up with the content for posting to your blog. So let's go ahead and jump into this. And my first point that we're going to cover is people. And that's very important in determining what your content is going to be. You need to identify target audiences and assess their social behavior. Who are your top audiences? These can include partners, evangelists, influencers, clients, or prospective clients, etc. I want you to name and describe three priority audiences that you'd like to engage and build relationships with. All right. When you do that, I want you to include the age, the demographics, what social media they use, anything that you can provide to help yourself better understand the behaviors and needs of your audience, and be as specific as possible. Include any supporting research such as surveys and industry data. So you need to put your priority audience 1, 2, and 3, and then segment them and provide that various information that I just stated to you. All right, number 2, objectives. What do you want to accomplish? What are the goals and objectives for each of the three top target audiences that we just established? I want you to describe your goals and objectives for this, as well as for each audience segment. And that should go like this. Here's your one audience and segment one. A, your objectives of what you want to achieve with this audience. And number two is the objectives the audience has for themselves. They can both be personal or professional. So you need to determine that. And take those three priority audiences and their segments and write down that information and record it. Okay, the next section is strategy. And that you need to plan for how the relationships will change from the post that you make. So for those clients who are in a contractual relationship with, say, my firm, you know, Generations Marketing, for the post strategy, then we will determine the social media strategy for each of these audiences. If not, then we need to provide you with, I'd say, additional information or stuff about, you know, strategy. So, I mean, you know, the only way I can do that is obviously listening to you on a case-by-case basis. So for all clients, we need your input as to how you would like the relationship to change with the identified audiences. And I would say describe how you want the relationship to change with the target audience. Do you want to start a new relationship, nurture an existing relationship, or improve upon the relationship that you already have? So you've got to state your strategy and plan how your relationships will change based on this new information that you provide to your priority audience in the segment. So the first question, like I said, you need to add underneath as you build this on your piece of paper is, how do you want the relationship to change or evolve with that target audience? And is it a transaction? Is it impersonal? Is it an occasional relationship? Or do you desire a more intimate, passionate relationship with that audience? And this goes for the same for each audience. So go ahead and do that now. All right, the next step is goals. You need to set goals for achievement, qualitative and quantitative. Here's a goal identification and summary. So we're gonna knock down your goals here. So I'm going to ask you some questions here. You need to write down the answers to these questions. And number one would be, what qualitative goals do you want to achieve? Number two is, what quantitative goals do you want to achieve? Number three is, will the goal benefit you or the people, meaning the audience? Number four, how will the goal benefit you? And number five, how will the goal benefit the audience? And number six, does the goal align to a broader business plan, goal, or objectives? And in that, you need to set some priorities, you know, maybe some common social media goals. In regards to the results that you want to achieve with social media, please rate the importance of each of the following common goals that I'm going to present to you right now. So you need to rank them from 1 to 5, 5 being the highest. So these are important points to keep in mind. Number one, brand awareness. Number two, brand loyalty. Number three, customer service. Number four, market research. Number five, competitive intelligence. Number six, shortened sales cycle. Number seven, customer loyalty. Number eight, lead generation. And number nine, revenue. All right, the next part that we need to go through in this process is the metrics. What metrics will be used to measure success? What qualitative and quantitative goals do you want to achieve? I'm going to ask you a series of questions here that you need to answer, because once again, this is an exercise I'm taking you through. Number one, do you have a measurement system in place today for measuring results with your social media? If yes, please describe. Number two, do you use paid or free tools to measure social media results? Please list tools used. Number three, What metrics will help measure success? Number 4, what tools are needed to measure success? Number 5, do you have the necessary tools? Number 6, what additional tools are required to accurately measure success? Number 7, is the data readily available? Number 8, will custom programming be needed to receive the metrics? Number 9, how frequently will the metrics be shared with the team? Number 10, do you have a standard process for keeping both the data and the tools up to date? If you need help with finding tools that are great for measuring metrics, and this goes beyond just, say, Google Analytics, like I've been referring in many of my programs, you need to check out a site called ezinegenerator.com, and that's E-Z-I-N-E, and then generator, the word generator, G-E-N-E-R-A-T-O-R.com. That's ezinegenerator.com, total online presence and resources. In their particular analytics section of the site, it has tons of resources and tools and reviews and look-over-the-shoulder videos, seminars, presentations, podcasts in regards to metrics. So check that out. And so the next session is having the business mindset and for assessment. So how ready are you to be a social business? This section helps assess your business readiness to adopt and achieve success with social media. This may or may not be discussed in detail as part of your engagements with, say, Generations Marketing, depending on the specifics of the project and agreed upon deliverables. So since I'm not really in this program consulting you direct, there really, you know, isn't anything as far as anything that's agreed upon as far as delivering any type of mindset or any kind of guarantees that I'm making you. I'm just walking through this as a exercise with you. So in regards to your readiness to become a social business, please rate the readiness on each of these following attributes and write them down. And rank them from 1 to 5 again, and 5 being high. Number 1, mindset. Number 2, stakeholder buy-in. Number 3, realistic expectations. Number 4, roles. Do you have proper resources allocated for social media integration? Number 5, customer profile. Number 6, market analysis. Number 7, competitive analysis and understanding. Number 8, processes to execute, implement, maintain, and integrate social media into your business. Number 10, organizational model. Number 11, communication. Number 12, education. 13 is monitoring. 14, reporting. 15, budget. And 16, social media policy. So you need to have the business mindset assessment of all those areas. Rank those areas from the most important being 1 to 5, 5 being the highest. This way you can concentrate on specific mindset. All right. Well, that is about it and covering this particular exercise with you. You should take the time to write all this down, and hopefully this will help you in determining your motivation in creating content and what you're going to post to your blog. So get the most from your post to your blog, and this is the best way of running through this particular exercise in order to determine what type of content, what your goals are, and all the rest in doing so. All right. I really, really, really appreciate you tuning into my show. If you like it, I consider subscribing to it, which you can do by visiting to my website, chaddecker.com. And if you are an iTunes or Stitcher Smart Radio listener, take it with you wherever you go on your mobile device. If you like my show and find it resourceful, please share it with your social network. And do it by sharing, liking, posting, leaving a comment, or subscribing to my show. I greatly appreciate your efforts and support. You are part of what makes this show a success. Well, that's about it for this show. Good morning, good evening, wherever you may be, across the nation and around the world. This is Chad Deckard signing off. Goodbye for now.